Today our topic is Wheatstone's bridge. Wheatstone's bridge is an arrangement of four resistors. It's a network of four resistors, a galvanometer and a cell. So here you can see the diagram. In the diagram, you can see four resistors. This is one resistor P. P is the resistance of the resistor. Another resistor Q. Another resistor S. And another R. We have four resistors. P, Q, R, S. Then we have a galvanometer connected. This is a galvanometer. The galvanometer has a resistance capital G. P is the resistance of this resistor. Here Q is the resistance. S is the resistance. R is the resistance. And galvanometer has a resistance G. We have connected a cell also. Cell is having an EM of capital E. So we have arranged the resistors, galvanometer and cell in this manner. In a quadrilateral shape. Now there are two corners, B and D are one pair of corner, A and C are other pairs of corner. Across B and D what we have connected the galvanometer. Across A and C what we have connected the cell. So in the quadrilateral shape, across two corners we have connected cell, across these two corners we have connected galvanometer. Across these two corners cell and across these two corners we have a galvanometer. Now I'll explain the division of current. From the cell, I is the current flowing like this. This current I divides here because there is a junction, it is dividing. I1 is flowing through P, I2 is flowing through R. Now I1 reaches here, it has two options to flow. Some current IG, galvanometer current, flows through galvanometer. What's the remaining current then? From I1, IG is flowing through galvanometer, remaining current is I1 minus IG flowing through the resistance Q. Here also, after I1, remaining current is I2. From I, some portion of current I1, remaining is I2. I2 is flowing through resistance R and reaching here. Here two currents reaching, IG and R. They will combine here at the junction. IG and I2 combine here. After combination, they will flow I2 plus IG in this direction. I1 minus IG in this direction, I2 plus IG in this direction, here they will combine. Now we will apply junction rule here. At a junction C, there are two currents coming. At a junction C, we have two currents. Which are the currents? I1 minus IG coming from the upper side. From lower side, we have the currents I2 plus IG. So they are summing up there. They are joining at the junction. What will be the net current? IG cancels. What will be the net current? I1 plus I2. I1 plus I2. I1 plus I2. I is equal to I1 plus I2. Because I splits as I1 and I2. So this current I will be equal to I1 plus I2 flowing in the lower arm. Then it reaches at the cell. From cell, I is the current leaving. And which is the current joining at the negative terminal? Same current I. This is the diagram. This is the diagram for Wheatstone's bridge. Now, here is a special condition for the Wheatstone's bridge. The condition is that if you select the resistors P, Q, R and S, there are four resistors, in such a manner that if you select the resistors such that there is a particular ratio, if the ratio is satisfied, no current flows through the galvanometer. Means the entire current reaching here will go to the resistance Q. Here the entire current reaching here will go to the resistance S. No current will enter in the galvanometer. So we need to find the ratio. So we need to select P, Q, R and S in such a ratio that no current flowing through the galvanometer. Now to get that condition or to get that balance, that's called balancing condition. We need to find the balancing. And when balancing condition is attained, no current flow through galvanometer. How can you say no current flow through galvanometer? If galvanometer is not carrying any current, galvanometer will not deflect. It will stay vertical, no deflection. If current flows in one direction, galvanometer will deflect to one side. Opposite direction, in opposite side. So when no current is flowing through galvanometer, it will remain vertical. So we need to find the condition such that no current flow through the galvanometer. That is balancing condition. Now we will see Kirchhoff's laws. We need to apply Kirchhoff's laws here. First we will apply the mesh rule for the loop. A loop or mesh A, B, D, A. Which is a loop? A, B, this is a loop. Starting from here, we will reach this is a loop. Second loop, we will consider B, C, D, B. Here, we need to traverse like this. This is the loop. In both loops, we are traversing in clockwise direction. So, first, we will find A, B, D, A. For the loop ABDA, we are traveling from A to B. This is the direction which we are traveling. Current also in same direction. What should be the sign of potential? Negative. What is the potential drop here? I1 into P. So we will give minus I1 into P. Then we are traveling downward. Current also downward direction. What is the voltage dropped into galvanometer? Ig into G. That also would be negative because current and traveling direction are in same direction. Now we are just going to move upwards. We are traveling like this, current in opposite direction. We have to give the potential positive. We are traveling against the current. So we will give the potential positive I2R. There is no cell in the network here. So in this branch there is no network. We will give it is equal to 0. Now we'll take the next loop. The loop name is BCDB. We'll start from B to C. When we travel from B to C, we are traveling like this in this direction, in the same direction of the current. So what is the what is the potential drop here? Negative. So we'll take negative of I1 minus Ig is the current through Q. Then we need to multiply the resistance of the resistor into Q. Current into resistance is the potential difference. Now we have traveled from B to C. Now we are going to coming in this direction. We are traveling in this direction, but current in upward direction. We need a positive value, positive of I2 plus Ig, because we are traveling in opposite direction as that of the current into S. Now we have reached here. Now we are moving upwards. We are moving upwards, current in downward direction. So we need to take positive Ig G. That's the voltage across the galvanometer, that should be equal to 0. So I'm giving equation number 1 and equation number 2. What's our condition? When the resistors are arranged in such a manner, particular manner, galvanometer current should be 0. So let us assume that galvanometer current is 0. Ig is equal to 0. So we need to modify these two equations. We need to make Ig 0. Here we have Ig 0. So this term will be eliminated. We can neglect this term. We can cut that term. Here, this Ig term we can cut. Here, we can cut this Ig term. Here, this entire term we can cut. What's our remaining terms then? For the loop ABDA, we have the remaining terms minus I1P plus I2R is equal to 0. For this loop, we have I1 is there, Q also there. Minus I1Q. Here, we have I2. Ig is cut. So, remaining is I2 into S. We have a plus I2S is equal to 0. We have got two equations, 3 and 4. We will take these two terms right side. We have minus I1P is equal to minus I2R. Here what we will do? Minus I1Q is equal to minus I2S. Already equation 5 and equation 6. I will divide these two equations. I minus I1P by minus I1Q. I1 cancels, minus also cancels, we get P by Q. Here what we will do, here also we will divide right side, I2 minus I2 cancel, we will get R by S. So, if we take resistors in such a ratio, P by Q is equal to R by S, then no current will flow through the galvanometer. Okay, again example also to understand this, I am taking the value P 40 ohms, Q I am taking a value 80 ohms. Here R I am taking a value 20 ohms. S I am taking a value 40 ohms. What will be the ratio? P by Q. P by Q. P by Q means 40 divided by 80. 40 by 80. What is R by S? 20 divided by 40. 20 by 40. 40 by 80 is equal to 1 by 2. 20 by 40 is equal to 1 by 2. This ratio is satisfied. So when this ratio is satisfied, what is specialty? The currents I1 reaching here will flow to Q. It will not flow to galvanometer. So galvanometer will not show any deflection. It will show null deflection. So when galvanometer shows null deflection here, what we can say? We can say the bridge is balanced. So this is Wheatstone's bridge. Now we have a device called a meter bridge. Meter bridge is widely used in laboratories to find the to compare resistances we can use to compare and to calculate the resistance of a wire, we can use the meter bits. Meter bit is actually a practical form of V-strand spreads. Okay, thank you.